First arrived at the entrance, you will see this wheelbarrow fire pit, which kind of reminds me of feng shui. Don't you think it's like one of those fish ponds that the Chinese restaurants tend to put all the time? They don't call it the potting shed for nothing. As you can see, there are green pots hanging all over the place, while the tree branches are wrapped with some warm decorative lightings, creating a cozy dining atmosphere. These two are not diners, by the way, they're actually the live singers. Can't really tell, huh? They have got quite a vintage looking lamp here, which kind of match with the plants and the surrounding. Well, even for the menu, they made the binder clip looks like a shelf, which again aligns with their gardening style. The drinking menu, they do have some really nice graphics for those drinks. Unfortunately, they are just graphics. They won't necessarily come in those appearances. And here comes our food. Next to this restaurant, there is a very shiny archway that catches my attention. After a bit of Googling, I realized that is the Garden of Sweets event. So I went to this website and booked it in advance. It costs $10 for one ticket. So, finger crossed. I hope it's all worthwhile. If you don't book it in advance, chances are you will not be allowed to go inside. So remember to grab the tickets online first before heading in. On a scale of 1 to 10, I think I'll probably give 8.5 for the food and drinks. Atmosphere, 9. Price, 7. Manner of the staff, 8.5. It's a good restaurant overall, and I do recommend it to all of you, especially for those who are visiting Sydney for the first time. By the way, where's my commission?